What if I told you there are legitimately secret hidden performance settings in Windows that can only be revealed using commands in the command prompt? It's true. Here are all the visible power and performance settings in Windows by default, and here are all the possible ones. There are so many more, including all these processor performance settings. So that's what we'll go over today, because I only just found out about these myself, so I just had to make a video about them, and of course I'll show you how you can see them for yourself. Oh, and this video is sponsored by World of Tanks, I'll talk about that later. So you're probably wondering what these settings are for, and why they're hidden. As you can see, they're actually found in the Advanced Power Options menu for the various power plans in Windows. The default plans you may have seen are Balanced, High Performance, and Power Saver. There's also the Ultimate Performance mode, but I'll mention that later. And to get to them, you just go into the Control Panel, System and Security, Power Options, Change Plan Settings, and then Change Advanced Power Settings. In my case, there were 28 settings visible by default, but if you include the hidden ones, there were 132. There are even a handful of entirely new groups of settings, such as Idle Resiliency, Interrupt Steering Settings, Graphics Settings, and Presence Aware Power Behavior. And I'll go over some of the more interesting settings in a bit, though some only show up depending on your computer, like this one for Intel graphics, which will only appear if you have an Intel CPU with integrated graphics. As for why these settings are hidden in the first place, well, realistically, you probably don't want to mess with many of these, if any at all. And since 99.99% of people will have no idea what these even do, let alone how to optimize them, plus the fact that changing them could really throw off your computer's performance, it makes sense they'd be hidden away. I mean, have you ever heard of Processor Idle Resiliency Timer Resolution? Me neither. That being said, I still think you should at least know about them, especially if you'd consider yourself an advanced user. Because while looking through these right now, you likely won't have a reason to change anything. It's possible you'll come across some obscure problem in the future where one of these might come in handy. So it's better to know they exist, but again, with the understanding that you shouldn't change them unless you have a specific reason to. Next, I'll go over how to enable the settings, but first I want to thank today's sponsor, World of Tanks. World of Tanks is free to play on PC with over 100 million players worldwide. There are more than 600 tanks, including destroyers, artillery, light, medium, and heavy tanks, so there's always new playstyles to try. There's a variety of maps with everything from open fields to urban industrial zones to deserts where you can flank by climbing a steep hill or sneak through a forest. There are actually over 40 arenas. The game has high historical accuracy plus inspiration, meaning the models and vehicles feel authentic. You can earn experience and modify your tank with various upgrades to be ready for any challenge. For example, I decided to add the powerful but slow howitzer to my tank for massive damage, and in one game, I destroyed the most enemy tanks out of everyone on my team. You can download World of Tanks with the link in the description, and during registration, use the promo code TANKMANIA for free 7 days premium account, 250,000 credits, the premium tank Excelsior, and 3 rental tanks for 10 battles each. Also check out World of Tanks merch on Amazon, the store link is in the description. And with all that being said, let's continue. Before we go into some of the specific settings, I may as well show you how to enable them, but it is a bit involved. To simply see a list of all the hidden settings and their current values, we can use the power config command in the command prompt. Normally, the parameter you'd use to see the current settings is the slash query parameter or slash Q. And then you can see it shows a list of the different settings, the possible values, and the current setting if the computer is plugged in versus on battery. But that slash Q command still only shows the settings that are already viewable in the GUI. So instead, we need to use an even more hidden command that is not even listed in the list of commands, which is slash QH. And this will show you all the settings, including the hidden ones. Though keep in mind, this only has the command prompt show all the settings. It doesn't actually enable them yet. Another useful tip though, is if you want to output the results into a text file instead of just showing it in the terminal window, you can add a greater than sign after the command along with the path of the file you want to save it into. So writing the commands like this will save them onto the desktop as text files. Now, as for getting these settings to show up in the power settings window, how it works for an individual setting is you do this command, powercfg-attributes. Then the alias of the subgroup or the subgroup's GUID, which is this big string of letters and numbers, then the GUID of the individual setting. And then to unhide the setting, you'd put minus attrib hide, or to rehide it, you'd put plus attrib hide. Obviously, with 100 plus hidden settings, this would take forever, but there are scripts like this one, which use PowerShell to get all the power settings on your computer, and then generates another script you can run to unhide every single one. Now, I'll put that link in the description, but I would not recommend most people do that, because you can't just reverse it. You see, that script just runs the unhide command on all settings, whether they're already visible or not. So if you tried to just reverse it by changing all the commands to rehide them, for example, you would literally hide every single power setting, including those that were visible before. And you can see, that's what I did here for a demonstration. They're all gone. So your only option would be to unhide everything again. So instead, what I think you should do is just use that text file with all the settings, and if you ever need to change one of them, you can just enable only that one or a few settings. That way you don't clutter up your power settings with 100 of them you're never gonna need. So next, why don't we take a look at some of the more interesting settings in here? Though again, I'm not saying you should change any, we're just looking. Under hard disk, there are settings for both hard drives and SSDs. There are a bunch of settings mentioning APST ITPT, which I found out stands for Autonomous Power State Transition, and Idle Time Prior to Transition, which apparently have to do with how long the drive is idle before changing power states. Under sleep, it mostly seems to be settings having to do with whether certain sleep policies are allowed or not. And under USB, it's mostly to do with selectively suspending devices, like those that are idle. I looked up these IOC and TD terms, which seem to stand for Interrupt on Change and Transfer Descriptor, but as for what this does, I have no idea. Idle Resiliency is an entire new settings group that showed up, and appears to have settings related to the computer's standby modes, and specifically, when to not go into standby, I think. For example, apparently programs can issue power requests that prevent the computer from turning off the display, going to sleep, stuff like that. So this setting, I guess, is for that. But I have no idea why the default setting is 136 years. Interrupt steering settings is also a new group, but I had a hard time finding these even being mentioned anywhere, let alone what they do. I did find a paper made by Intel for developers that basically said, don't mess with this stuff, let Windows handle it. So that's what you should probably do too. Now the processor power management group is pretty interesting because by default it just has two settings, minimum processor state and maximum processor state. And if you want to max things out, just use the high performance plan, which puts both at 100%, so your CPU is always running at full frequency if you don't care about power usage or battery life. But there are a ton of hidden settings as you can see. A lot of them have to do with something called core parking, where basically certain cores go into a sort of sleep mode. I wouldn't even mess with these settings because if you really want to get maximum performance from a computer and don't care about power consumption, you can just go into the BIOS and disable C states altogether, which are lower power states for cores, including parking. Linus Tech Tips actually did a video where his computer was having weird issues and disabling C states fixed it. So I'll have a link to that pop out and in the description if you want to learn more about that. It might be worth considering. But yeah, this section has too many settings to cover, and if all you want is the highest performance, well, the high performance plan seems to max out anything important anyway. Under graphics settings, this might only show up if you have multiple GPUs, but it lets you set a preference for a low power GPU if you want. Like on my computer, it considers the integrated GPU as power saving, which makes sense. Though interestingly, the only other option is none, so I guess it defaults to the high performance one. Under display, nothing too crazy here. For example, this advanced color quality one apparently has to do with whether the OS will use HDR and wide color gamut for certain content, or be biased towards power saving battery. Though not sure how much that even makes a difference, because even in the power saving power plan, it still sets it to visual quality. The last new settings group is presence aware power behavior, though some of these might show up by default for devices that have a so-called presence sensor, which seems to be mostly a thing for laptops. Anyway, these apparently have to do with power saving actions based on whether you're in front of your computer or not, like whether it turns off the display when you walk away, for example. So those are all the settings that were hidden before, but one thing I noticed is that some settings will show in the list printed out by command prompt, but still won't show up in the power settings window even if you unhide them. For example, the entire group of battery settings doesn't show despite being listed, which makes sense, the computer has no battery. There are also some display settings like display brightness and dimming settings, which I assume only show up on a laptop or tablet where the OS has control over the screen brightness. There might be more, but I didn't look through every single one. Okay, now one thing you might be wondering about is that Ultimate Performance Power Plan, which is actually built into Windows, but only shows up by default if you're using the Pro for Workstations or Enterprise editions of Windows. Though there are articles that show you how you can easily enable it yourself on any edition. I'll put the link in the description. Microsoft said that this Ultimate Performance Plan was built upon the High Performance Plan, but it was optimized to reduce micro latencies. But what exactly is the difference with the Ultimate Performance Mode? That's actually what got me started with this video, because if you just look at the default power options, it seems exactly the same as the high performance, except it disables your hard drive from going idle. That's it. I figured there had to be more behind the scenes, which is how I came across all those hidden power settings. And I thought, ah, it all makes sense. All the differences are just in the hidden settings, except there still weren't any. I exported all the settings for both the high performance power plan and the ultimate performance plan, and they are literally exactly the same, except for that one setting for hard drive idle time. And yes, I'm using a legitimate activated enterprise edition of Windows 11. So if you were wondering if I had to use the command to enable ultimate performance and maybe it wasn't the real mode, nope, that's not the case. I even made a virtual machine with the 2018 version of Windows 10 Pro for Workstations right after the Ultimate Performance Mode was released, thinking maybe at the time there were differences, but not anymore. But nope, back then, same thing. So I am truly puzzled. I have no idea whether somehow this Ultimate Performance Mode somehow activates some code behind the scenes that's not related to power settings, but I would be surprised if that was the case. Or it might just be 100% marketing, so people feel assured they are getting the absolute most from their computer, even though they were with the high performance too. Or maybe it's there in case in the future there are settings where it will be different. In any case, even if it is placebo, I'll still keep it on that mode, because why not? So now you know more than you will likely ever need to know about Windows power settings, but at least you can keep it all in the back of your head just in case. You never know, maybe you'll need to impress your boss or a friend with your expert computer knowledge. But like I said, you probably don't want to mess with those anyway unless you have a specific reason and know what you're doing. Thanks again to World of Tanks for sponsoring. Be sure to check out the link in the description and use the promo code TANKMANIA for all those bonuses I mentioned before. So if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to let me know down in the comments, especially if you know something about the settings that I didn't. Also, be sure to give the video a big thumbs up for the algorithm and maybe check out some of my other recent videos and consider subscribing. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about why storage drives in Windows seem to be smaller than advertised. It's probably not what you think. I'll put that link right here. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.